Check 1, 2, and I just gave a little spiel and my mic was not on. So, hello, welcome to Strong AF. Today we're gonna do a variations on a theme style workout. Go ahead and grab your weights, your dumbbells, your kettlebells, whatever it is that you normally use. Household items, water jugs, milk jugs, a big bag of kitty litter, rice, sugar, anything like that, pasta sauce jars, wine bottles, cans of vegetables. Take about 30 seconds and grab that stuff. Also make sure that you've got some water. Just a couple seconds here, you guys.
You came here to do. Now bust it open, let me see you get loose. It's going down for real. It's going down for real.
All right, you guys, let's get this party started. Go ahead and grab your lightest weights that you're going to plan to use. Today we are doing a variations on a theme workout, and I said this a moment ago, but my mic was muted, so I'm gonna say it again. We're gonna start each round. Sorry, we've got two different exercises per block of work, and we're gonna start four different rounds. We're gonna start with the regular exercise, then we've got the isometric hold we're gonna add, then we're gonna add a pulse. Fourth round, we're gonna change up the tempo and go super slow. So, same exercise, just variations on that exercise. So first with a warm-up, grab those light weights, set them down close to you. We're gonna start to stretch out a little bit and get those muscles ready for action. And restart that song here. Let's take a wide stance. Take your chin down to your chest and just roll shoulder to shoulder. And look side to side like you're shaking your head no. Big shoulder rolls. Checking all my settings. Mic should be on. Roll forward. Wouldn't be one of my classes without some kind of technical issue. Even if they're the ones that are my fault. Now go ahead and grab those weights. Stand up nice and tall, heels under the hips, chest lifted, core tight. Nice and easy deadlift down to the knees and rise. Tip, two, and rise. Now we're gonna add a rope down. Take the elbows wide, bring them back down, and stand up tall. Come again, tip it down. Pull the elbows wide, take them back, and stand up. Let's speed that tempo down, row, down, and rise. We tip, row, tip, stand tall. Slight bend in the knees, just a little bend. You wanna feel that pull in the hamstrings. All right, let's take the elbows to 90. Up and down. Side raises here, warming up those shoulders. Elbows high, right under the shoulders, making a rotator raise, lift. Open, control it down. Lift. Yes. Couple more times. Let's step a little bit wider. Slow squat. Let's bring those weights up here. Again, slow. Slow on the way up. Again. Now this time on the way up, let's press those arms all the way up to the sky. Bring them down. Slow to the top. Single squats, just the squat without the arms. Yes. Stay with me. Warming up those legs. Pulse at the bottom, pulse for three. Two, one, to the top again. Three, two, one, whoop. Oh yeah. One more time. Alternating backward stepping lunge. Other leg, long step, lunge, up, and in, long step. Yeah. Ooh. Pulse, 3, 2, 1, step it in. Step, 3, 2, 1, yes. One more each leg. Ow, 3, 2, 1, stand in the center, alternating hammer curls. Knuckles facing out, elbows in right by the ribs. Now both, elbows stay under the shoulders. Don't let them sneak forward or back. Done, set those weights down, take a quick shake. We should be feeling warm, heart rate up a little bit, muscles ready. All right, so let's do this. We're gonna alternate two exercises each block. Like I mentioned, we're gonna do a different theme each round. Makes sense, hopefully. So first round, the OG. Second round, we're gonna add an isometric hold. So for example, squats, drop, hold, slow on the way up. Right, that little pause at the bottom is gonna force you to recruit more muscle fibers. It's gonna make it a little bit harder to get back to the top. Then we're gonna add a pulse for round 3 for both exercises. Then we're gonna go super slow tempo on the last one, all right? So first block, squats and diamond squats. Okay, so regular old fashioned squats, diamond squats. You're gonna stand up nice and tall on the toes if you can, bring your heels to touch, down and up. So go kind of heavy on your regular squat if you can, if you're feeling good. You don't need any weights at all if you want to just use body weight for this round, okay? Or you might want to go a little lighter on your diamond squat since we're throwing that balance into the mix. So here we go, 30 seconds each, first round. Good old fashioned regular squats, and go. 30 seconds, feet should be right outside hip distance apart. And you're sitting your booty back and down, stopping it right above the knee line. Like you're sitting in an invisible chair. Whew. Yes, 10 more seconds. Then we got that diamond squat coming up. Oh yeah, big squeeze in the glutes at the top. 3, 2, 1, diamond squat. You can drop your weight, you can hold it up here, you can grab something lighter, however you wanna do it. Stay on the toes if you can, or flat feet right here with the toes turned out a little bit. See that diamond in between the knees? Oh yeah, working those calves and the glutes, feeling it? 5 seconds, 3, 2, 1. Now regular squat, we're gonna add that isometric hold. Ready, drop, hold, up for 2. Down for 1, hold for 1, 2 counts up to the top. Oh yes. Can you feel the difference? Starting to feel that little fire in your quads? Ow! Oh yeah, less than 10 seconds. Then we do the same type of movement with that diamond squat. Adding that isometric hold. Ready? Here we go, let's do it. Stand up nice and tall. Drop, hold. Ooh. Down, hold. Slow to the top. Oh yeah. Halfway through it. Ooh, a big squeeze in the glutes at the top. Yes. Less than 10 seconds. Next round, we're gonna add that pulse. Ooh, 3, 2, 1. Back to your regular squat. And pulse. Get low, get low. Now, you can just do a few pulses. You can even do 1, right? Down, halfway up, down, and rise. Or max it out, keep it down low. You got this. Woo! As many pulses as you can. And then come up, almost there, you guys. 5, 4, 3, 2. Yes, diamond squat. Stand up tall on the toes if you can. Flat feet are fine, remember? Pulse it. Yeah. Squeeze those glutes every rep. Whoa. Whoo. Stay low in the bottom range as long as you can. Oh yes. 3, 2, 1, whoo. Regular squat, slow. slow. Don't rush. Oh, feel that? Legs should really be shaking right now. Push the floor away through those heels. You got this. Oh, yeah. 5 seconds. 4, 3, 2, diamond squat. Same deal. Nice and slow. Oh, goodness. Yes. Almost there, almost there. Almost to our first little break. I know you're ready to shake those legs out. Embrace that tension. Feel that burn. 3, 2, 1, and yes. Finish it up. Woo. Drop those weights if you got them. Shake it out. Oh, I meant to go heavier. I thought that felt a little light. Still really hard. Give your legs a quick stretch if you need it. Woo. Quick quad stretch. Quick calf stretch. Pressing the back heel down to the floor. Oh, yeah. Woo. So up next, we're going to work our chest and our back. We've got a wide row. Where's my other? I lost a weight. Well, anyway, we're going to do a wide row and then push-ups. Nope, I didn't lose it. It's right here. I thought I had taken out another one. Woo. All right. I'm organized now. So wide row with your weights. You're going to tip forward. Here's your angle. Knuckles facing the front. And wide row, right here. So medium to heavy. Have a couple different sizes close by, because you might want to swap them out, especially by like that second or third set. And then our push-ups, hands go wide, chest down to elbow height, and then push the floor away through the heel of the palm. You can be on your toes, you can be on your knees right here, or you can even bring your knees in closer, right underneath the hips, right there, to drop the intensity down a little bit. Ready for that wide row. Grab your weights, stand up nice and tall, heels into the hips, and go. Regular row. No big deal, right? Knuckles facing forward. Row. Now you can row as many times as you want. You can do a single and stand. Make it a four count movement. 1, 2, 3, 4. Or stay there and just keep rowing. Oh, yes. Elbows out wide, squeeze the shoulder blades together. 3, 2, 1, whoo! Push-ups, the OG push-up, no big deal. Hands go wide on the toes or on the knees. Woo! Brace hard through your core. I want you to think about relaxing your shoulders away from your ears. Don't tense up. Where's my timer? 5 seconds. Come on, come on. 3, 2, 1. Come on up. Woo. Back to your wide row with the isometric hold. So we're gonna lift, hold, slow on the release. Lift, hold, take it down slow. Woo. Yes. Remember I told you to have a couple different sizes and I didn't take my own advice? Be prepared. Oh yeah. 3, 2, 1. Come on down to the floor for that push-up with the isometric hold. Hands are wide, drop low, hold, slow push. Ooh. Ooh yeah. On the toes if you can. Try one on your toes. Ow! Remember that easier option, knees under the hips. If you're already on your knees and you're struggling, bring them in closer. 3, 2, 1. Woo! Come on back up. Wide row with the pulse. Oh, yes. So you can keep pulsing the whole time or just do a couple, right? Woo! Almost there. Stay with it, you guys. 4, 3, 2, One pulsing push-up. Say what? We got this. Come down low. Get low. Stay low. Or just do a couple pulses. Or just do one, right? Down, half, down, up. Woo! Yeah. Almost there. 5 seconds. Come on. 3, 2, 1. Woo! Super slow row. Woo. We got this. Lift those elbows high. Take them out wide. Squeeze those shoulder blades together. Slow. Oh! Everything's shaking, yes? Oh yeah. 3, 2, 1. Push-ups. Slow, slow, slow. Wide hands, chest down to elbow height. Push the floor away. Woo! On the knees if you need to. Knees in right under the hips if you need to. Oh, 10 seconds. Oh, almost to that next break, you guys. Come on, 5, 4, 3, 2. Finish up the movement. Woo! Oh my, shake it out. Clasp your hands behind your back. Lift your chest. And let's take our forearms to our quads. Round out the back. Slowly roll up. Ooh. Yes. So we're gonna work our biceps and our triceps in this next round. Bicep curls, overhead extensions. So for your biceps, right here. So we did hammer curls in our warm-up, keeping the knuckles out. We're actually gonna twist at that mid-range mark here, right? Overhead extensions, go a little heavier if you're feeling it with just one weight. You're gonna take it up overhead. I'm gonna go at an angle so I don't hit my ceiling. Then you can have heels under hips or split your stance down and extend up. You can also do these on the knees if you prefer that. All right, so pick up your weights for your bicep curl. The OG bicep curl right here, ready, go. Heels under the hips. Oh, those are two different sizes, Emmy. Elbows in, right next to the ribs. Oh yeah. Elbows stay under the shoulders. Don't forget to add that little twist. If it's a little too much, you can just do the hammer curl. Keep the knuckles out. Oh yeah. Elbows in, elbows right under the shoulders. Don't let them sneak forward or back. Control on the way down. Overhead extension. Ready? I want you to pretend like there's magnets. There are magnets on the insides of your elbows, pulling your elbows in toward each other. Yes, don't let those elbows flare out. Take that weight down to the base of the neck, full extension to the top. Ow! We've got our isometric hold coming up in 3, 2, 1. Oh, go back to your two weights. Bicep curl. So we lift, hold, take it down for 2. Lift for 1, hold for 1, down for 2. Oh yeah. Keep breathing. Breathe out on the hard part. Control. Don't let gravity do the work for you. 3, 2, 1. Overhead extension. Drop and hold, slow on the way up. Oh yes. Ow. Hang in. All the way to the base of the neck, fully extend to the top. Oh yeah. Feeling that? Oh, burning in the back of the arm. 3, 2, 1. Here comes that pulse. Ready? Right here in the mid-range for your bicep pulse. 1 inch above and 1 inch below that 90 degree mark. Ow. 1 inch above, 1 inch below. It's a small movement. Little pulse right here. Oh my goodness. 4, 3, 2, 1. Oh. Overhead extension. Drop it low. Pulse it. Many pulses as you can. Anytime you need to, just take it up to the top. Just do a couple. You can do 3. You can do 1 and extend. You choose. There's always a way to modify the exercise. Make it your own. Just keep moving. 3, 2, 1. Are you ready for that super slow round? It's ready for you. Come on. Oh. Feel it? You should feel that burn. Arms should be shaking. Ooh, all the way up in line with the shoulders, all the way down to the thighs. Oh, you're almost there. Almost there. Woo! 3, 2, 1. Overhead extension. Go back to my heavy one and see how this goes. Oh, yes. Super slow. Woo! Hang in. Almost through it. Grit your teeth. Come on. Squeeze those elbows in. 3, 2, 1. Finish it up. Get there to the end. Oh, my word. Woo! Shake those poor arms. Let's give a quick stretch. Open the arms wide, point your thumbs down, push back. Bicep stretch, and then quick tricep stretch. Grab one elbow, grab the other elbow. Woo! Yes, you guys, killing it. We've got some wonderful compound movements coming up next. So light to medium, we're gonna work legs and shoulders, right? So kind of light. Lighter medium-ish. We've got a squat press, and that's okay. You can modify if you've got a low ceiling like I do. We're gonna figure out some things. And then we've got a lunge with a side raise. So you're just gonna alternate backward stepping lunges with a side raise. So for your original, this here, right? Long step back, add the arms. For your squat press, we're actually gonna do that one first. You're just gonna go squat, and press, right? So if you can't do that, that's okay. Just bring them here, or you can go here and do a little curl, right? No big deal. Find what feels right. Find what works for you in the space that you have available to you, right? Are we ready? Squat press, regular old squat press. Go. Regular tempo, nothing crazy. And careful not to look up, like I'm looking up because I'm trying to make sure I'm not gonna hit my ceiling. Do that once and then just keep going. You wanna keep your neck in line with your spine. Nice neutral spine, looking straight ahead. Oh yeah. Ow! 3, 2, 1. Here comes that lunge with the side raise. So elbows at 90. Long step back, take the arms up, elbows high, right under the shoulders. Oh yes, lots of work this round. So up next, round 2, remember we've got that isometric hold. 3, 2, 1, back to your squat press. So we're gonna go squat, hold, press up for 2. Down, hold, press. Ooh. Almost through this one. Ooh. 3, 2, 1. Woo. Elbows to 90. Step back and hold. Slow on the way in. Back and hold. Slow on the way in. You can also do here, slow on the way up. Then step, long step back, drop. You're gonna feel it more like that than if you step in. on that return. So you got here, or here, or here, slow, and then step. Woo! And that was it for that round. Up next, we got our pulse. So we're gonna pulse low, do a triple, and then press. 3, 2, 1. I know I said options before, but we're gonna try to stay on the same one. This time, 3, 2, 1, press. 3, 2, 1, woo! Make sure we're getting that arm action too. 3, 2, 1. All right, elbows at 90. Step back, we go 3, 2, 1, up, in. Long step, 3, 2, 1, up, step in. Just makes it less complicated to not have so many options on these, because it's a little tricky. Woo! 2, 1. We're gonna do one more each side. We're going a little long in this round, that's okay. Last time, long step, 3, 2, 1, up, in, super slow. Squat press, slow, slow on the way up, press. Oh yeah, woo! Nice and slow, embrace the burn. 3, 2, 1. Elbows at 90, long step, slow. Oh yes. Step it in, step it back with the other side. Slow. You can go at your own pace. Ooh, just make sure it's slow. Yes. 3, 2, 1. Done with that one. Ah, quick stretch for the shoulders. Quick stretch for the legs. Quad stretch, press the heel into the glute. Woo, we got one more to go, you guys. You are crushing it. Thank you for working so hard today. One more. We've got crunches, hip bridges. So you won't need any weights. You can, though. If you want a light to medium for your crunch, hold that weight, not quite up to your forehead, but almost touching. Just like that. And on your hip bridge, hold it on your hips, lift. Or no weights, fingertips at your temple, slide your ribs toward your hips, lifting the upper body, shoulder blades up off the floor. Hip bridge, arms at your sides, feet on the floor, lift your hips high, big squeeze in the glutes, lower down with control. All right, good old fashioned crunch. Ready and go. Woo. Weight or no weight. Fingertips at your temples if you're not using a weight. If you've got it, your elbows are up toward the ceiling. You're holding that weight up close toward the forehead. Regular old crunches. I'm going kind of slow. I don't know why I'm doing that. Regular crunch. You can go slow if you really want to. 3, 2, 1. Hip bridge, weight or no weight. Arms at your sides if you don't have the weight. Hold the weight on your hips if you are using it. Lift the hips high, big squeeze in the glutes. We're working the whole posterior chain here if we're doing it correctly. Lift high, big squeeze. Don't let gravity do the work. Don't just let your booty fall down onto the floor. And 3, 2, 1. Back to your crunch with the isometric hold. So we lift, hold, down for 2. Lift for 1, hold for 1, and down for 2. Woo! Yes. Ow. Oh yeah. Where are we on time? Almost there. 4, 3, 2, 1. Hip bridge. Feet on the floor, lift the hips high, big squeeze. Control on the way down, lift, hold, down. Woo. lift, squeeze. You get it. This is our last block of work, you guys. We got this. Come on. Ah, yeah. Keep breathing. 3, 2, 1. Add the pulse. Crunch. Here we go. Crunch. Crunch. Just like I've been saying in almost every other round, every other set, rather, you can do as many pulses as you want. You can just do a couple. You can pulse the whole time. Woo! If you want to make it a little bit extra, reach the arms toward the ankles. If you're not using the weight or if you're holding two weights, maybe you want super hardcore. 3, 2, 1. Release. Hip bridge with the pulse. Lift those hips high and pulse. Big squeeze every time you pulse. Squeeze that booty. Woo! Yes. Almost there, you guys. Ow! Come on, come on. Big squeeze. Hold, hold, hold. 3, 2, 1, and crunch. Super slow. Super slow. I think I lost my music. I don't know what happened there. That's okay. We're still moving. I did lose music. Just keep coming, you guys. Sorry, there's no music. We're almost there. What a drag. I don't know what happened. See you again. There's always something. 3, 2, 1. Super slow hip bridge lift. Super slow. Big squeeze. Take it down. Come on, come on. Slow on the way up, big squeeze. Slow and controlled on the way down. You should feel that everywhere. Whole posterior chain, hamstrings, glutes, lower back. Feeling it in the core. Oh yes. 5, 4, 3, 2, done. Oh, awesome, awesome job. Take a moment, grab a drink. Yeah, no idea what happened there. Let's see. Guess it's just that song. I got muted for some reason. I don't know, guys. I try to use royalty-free music, and sometimes it gets shut down anyway. So, let us cool down. It's not the song I wanted. I don't know why I clicked on that one. Cool down time. Let's chill. Take that energy down to a different level. Woo! Thanks so much, you guys, for working out with me. If we're working so hard today, let's do a quick stretch. Woo! Let's start with a quad stretch. Press the heel into the glute. Knees close together, hold on to something if you're feeling a little wobbly. Stand up nice and tall, feel that nice stretch through the front of that leg. Now that foot that you're holding onto, I want you to let go of it and step it down in front. Shift your weight back, tip at your hips. Flex that front foot and reach down toward your toes. Or if you're not feeling very flexible, gentle hands right above the knee. Also fine, so that back knee is bent, front leg is straight. Reaching toward the toes, toward the floor, or hands right above the knee. Ooh. And then we're gonna gently come up, take that front foot and step it back behind you. Drop down into the knees, tuck your tailbone under, and then the arm that is on the same side as the leg that's stepped back is gonna come across. Relax the shoulder down. So we're getting a hip flexor stretch downstairs, shoulder stretch up here. Slow deep breaths in through the nose, out through the mouth. And let's gently come up. Take that arm that's across, take it back behind you. Grab hold of the elbow. And you're gonna press that back foot, that back heel, down into the floor. So you're getting a tricep stretch up top, calf stretch. If you don't feel that wonderful stretch in your calf, step back a little bit more or bend into that front knee a little bit more. Ooh. And let's step into the center. Quad stretch on the other side. Knees close together, pressing the heel into the glute. Stand up tall. Feel that right here. If you want to add a little bit of a deeper stretch to your quad stretch, if you're in your living room, you don't have to do it right now, but you can put those toes up on like the back of your couch. Kind of lean in a little bit. Let go of that foot. Place it in front. Shift the weight back. Tip at the hips. Bend that back knee. Straighten the front leg. Flex the front foot. Reach down toward the toes or toward the floor or hands right above the knee. And then gently come up, take that front foot, step it behind, drop down into the knees, tuck the tailbone under, reach that arm across, shoulder stretch, hip flexor stretch. Gently come up, take that arm that's across back behind you, grab hold of that elbow, flatten your back heel down into the floor. For your tricep and calf stretch. Music stop again, really? Huh. Interesting. Hold that stretch for another couple of seconds. Deep breath in through the nose, out through the mouth. Step in and let's reach both arms forward. Keep stretching. I don't know if I just, for some reason, have to press play every time now. Nope. It's all right. Hold on, I want some kind of music on. There we go. Hopefully it's not super high energy. Or maybe it's just broken, no idea. No, that one's not playing either, huh? Well, that's okay, we are nearly done. Open up the arms, big lift through the chest. Relax the shoulders down. A couple more big deep breaths into the nose, out through the mouth, and then take your arms down. Clasp your hands behind your back, lift your chest. Bring those hands up toward the ceiling a little bit. Hold there. Then try to bring your palms to touch. Ooh, big stretch. And release, shake it out. Couple big shoulder rolls here. You guys, we are all done. Thank you again for working out with me. I hope you enjoyed this format. I love this one. Have an amazing day. Well, that song plays. No idea what's going on. Anyway, thank you again. I'm going to put all of my, and it stopped, all of my social media information up here for you to see in case you are not with me yet on Facebook, Instagram, YouTube, all of the things. Everything's right there. Also, my workouts are always free, but I always appreciate any donation. So my link to PayPal for a one-time contribution or my Patreon if you want to give regularly. Thank you so much again, you guys. Have a great day. Take care. I'll see you next time.
Take it back to the old school.